together. And I'm sure it's very good. And, you know, I think people can use essential oils and they can use medicines together. You have to be a little bit careful. And I'm becoming quite interested now in using essential oils with medicines together. But it can be done. You don't have to have one or the other. You can have both. You know, I think so that's what I'd like people to know. There's a choice.
Rebecca, in your book, Essential Oils for Happy Living, I'm going to quote you. You say, the most important decisions we make, the ones that rule our lives and determine the outcome of our personal stories, are generally emotion-based. I know I've heard you give a presentation that can go an hour or 2 hours, which is incredible, but in just a couple of minutes, what practical advice can you give us to help keep ourselves emotionally fit? What do we need to be doing?
Well, it is a loaded question, but emotional intelligence, or the ability to understand our emotions and relate to what we're feeling and to communicate that effectively and manage emotions, is actually shown to be the key to our success in life, much more so than our IQ. We used to think that the smarter we were, the more successful we would be, but we now know that the better we manage our emotions, the more successful we'll be. So it's an important question that you ask. So what do we do? Well, the steps in emotional intelligence, and let me just say, you can develop emotional intelligence. A lot of people think, I have emotional stuff, maybe I have trouble with anger management or whatnot, but you can change the brain has plasticity. So the components of emotional intelligence really give the answers away. So the first is awareness. Awareness is more than half the battle. So just learning to train yourself to be aware of what you're feeling. And then second would be managing those feelings, so self-management, learning how to manage it after you know what you feel. And doTERRA has provided us with a wonderful kit for that, and I don't know that the owners may have realized how powerful the emotional aromatherapy kit is, not just for the oils, but for the process of emotional intelligence. When you use it, and those of you who have used it, you flip open that lid, and you do have to identify the emotion that you're feeling and then pick the oil that would be best suited for that. So for this group, the best thing you can do is go home and start using your emotional aromatherapy kit and get into the habit of identifying your emotion, picking an oil that would work for you. And if you are a person who has a lot of emotion that comes up, and maybe you have what I call an amygdala hijack, where emotions just take you over and you get angry or send an email or do something that you know you didn't want to do. You said something to your children, you wish you hadn't said that. Right? Am I the only? Okay. So in those moments, if you have just even a go-to that you can lean to, and from our last convention, we had great research showing that the Forgive blend would be a fantastic one for you to just put in your purse or in your bag and just have it readily available for you, so that if you start to feel the emotions coming on, then you can quickly have a go-to. And that is taking the first two steps of emotional intelligence. It's awareness and management. And then just to really quick, and I won't go on forever, but I have to add to that we often think our emotions are only about us, but actually we are part of a massive network of all individuals who live on the planet. And any mother knows that just one grumpy child can ruin everything at home. So your emotions aren't just about you. And that brings us to the other part of the components of emotional intelligence, and that is social awareness, being aware of how you feel and how others feel, and being able to manage that. And that would apply to your teams, folks. You've noticed that if you're a grumpy leader, you might manifest some grumpy leaders, okay? So your emotional state affects your team and your family. And so again, becoming aware is your first step, and then learning to manage that. And I just love that we have essential oils that are instant for supporting us in solving that, because their interaction with the olfactory system and all that will stop there. Okay.